and then reinstated in 96. Last year won the regular season and then won the conference title.
So you're talking about from 96 until now, Portland State really making a nice jump in terms of perception and in terms of wins and losses. Their best three-year run here right now.
Yep. There's the situation. Timeout arrow, or the possession arrow going to Portland State. Both teams with two timeouts as Marquise Navarre faces a little bit of pressure from Dominguez.
And Dominguez known for his defensive, for his offense, but watching defensively, quick hands there on ball.
Johnson, Costin a little bit late, Johnson a little bit strong. Vikings content to walk it up as we approach the 1 minute mark.
I still like that call by Montana State. Brandon Johnson has shot the ball really well from three during the tournament. He had a good look.
Vikings trying to run some clock.
Well, they basically have two-point guards on the floor, Dominguez and Waters. Tough to defend.
Take it down to six on the shot clock, and Dominguez threw it away. Right to Brandon Johnson. One possession game. Less than a second difference. Shot clock and game clock.
Like the fact that Brad Hughes did not call timeout. Trying to get a quick hitter here.
Now he does. He doesn't like the way things look offensively, so he's going to call the timeout. He's down to one timeout left. You like that. Try to get that bucket before the defense can really get set up. But then once you see it and they're not in a position he likes, you call a timeout.
I thought Marquise Navarre would try to break his defender down off the dribble. That's when it's usually the best. When you don't call timeout, you let the point guard go and try to get a quick bucket or an opportunity for his teammate.
So a bid to the NCAA tournament on the line here in Ogden, Utah, the Big Sky Championship. The Bobcats trying to get back there for the first time since 96. Portland State looking to get back there for the second time.
Well, and right now, what Montana State has done on the offensive end, the ball has gone through Divaldo Bunga on the block. You need a three-point opportunity here, Terry, but if I'm Brad Hughes, I may try to go to Bunga quickly in the first 3 to 4 seconds, see if he can get a strong move at the hole, maybe an and-one situation, score, and then try to come up with a steal or foul.
On the campus of Weber State, they won the regular season in the Big Sky. They were the number one seed, but they were knocked off last night in the semis by Montana State. Terry Gannon, Stephen Bardo, and the Bobcats trying to pull off yet another upset within striking range of Portland State. And that man's had a good evening. Julius Thomas in the middle, and Jeremiah Dominguez has had a huge game at the point guard spot for the Vikings. Another timeout taken. Ken Bohm takes a 30. So both teams down to one timeout.
It looked like Coach Ken Bohm from Portland State was trying to look at the setup there, how Montana State was going to go into their offensive execution that time.
Remember last year, Dominguez, the player of the year in the conference, plays up to that tonight. An expectation. Dominguez, who had 10 in the semifinal game against Idaho State, been a much bigger factor this evening.
Well, he's had the ball in his hands the majority of the second half, and he usually makes the right decision, whether to go on his own or set up his teammates. So, as usual, as we expected, he's had a tremendous effect on this outcome.
As a player, you remember this type of pressure? You get 18.9 seconds. You know that your entire season, or your senior year career, might be over unless you come away with a double. And that's it, the finality of that. Navarre dishes out. They swing it. Johnson to three over Costin. Yeah! He got it! And we are tied. No timeout called. Vikings looking for the win. Waters dishes down. Thomas the dunk. Not over yet. Timeout Montana State.
That's what I expected to see from Montana State. Just going with no timeout. Dominic Waters made a tremendous play at the hole, drawing the defense with the dish.
Before the defense could get set up, they go straight to the hoop. So a two-point lead for the Vikings with 3.5 seconds remaining.
Watch here. Marquise Navarre gets all the way to the hole, kicks out Brandon Johnson, showing you the ice water. And that time, that's after the dunk there by Julius Thomas. Set up nicely by Dominique Waters.
And Ken Bowden, you start to celebrate and then go, whoops, there's 3.5 seconds left. I better not do this.
Well, there's some excitement all the way around with opportunity to go to the big dance for Portland State.
And now you've got 3.5 seconds left if you are Montana State to keep this game alive. And all year long, you work on these situations. And now for a trip to the NCAA tournament, it comes down to this.
And don't be surprised to see some misdirection action and a long pass to try to get the ball to Brandon Johnson for a three-point shot opportunity once again. Because he hit that last three with a lot of confidence.
55% from the floor tonight. Brad Hughes doesn't care about that right now. He cares about one possession, one final opportunity. It's Brandon Johnson taking the ball out.
A little surprised by that. They might try to get Will Bynum on the run. He gets three bounces with 3.5 seconds left.
They throw it to half court and rush. They called timeout.
Almost a full 2 seconds went off. 1.7 goes off the clock. Start at 3.5. And that's a situation where you have to let the official know that you want to call timeout. There was some hesitation on the officials recognizing the call.
So they'll meet with 1.8 seconds remaining.
Let's take a look here.
See the clock, they get it to half court.
Should at least be 3 seconds left on that clock, Terry.
Looked like Rush was looking to an official who wasn't there at one end to call the timeout.
Right.
And it took him an extra second then to turn around to an official at this end and call it.
Again, but in that situation, if you know that's what you're going to do, you have to alert the officials.
Absolutely.
Beforehand.
Yep.
And obviously that wasn't done. So we'll see if they get rewarded with some extra time, but
1.8 seconds. You do have time to inbound the ball and make a regular move and take a shot.
Yes, you do. Let's see it again. We see the two officials in the screen right there. Eric Rush turns around. And since we can't see the other official in the shot there, I'm assuming that he's along the baseline where Rush is pointing.
It's the only thing I can imagine. But he did not get the timeout right away. So they are going to put time back on the clock, and we're told it's going to be 3.1 seconds.
I think that's the exact call. It's a great call. The official's getting it right. There's so much on the line in this particular game that you want to get this absolutely right.
And we're told they gave us the word it would be 3.1, but now they're going to talk it over again and take another look.
Watch Terry, as soon as he catches and turns, right there. He's pointing for the timeout at 3.3, so I thought a 3.1 would be judicious.
It wasn't a clear timeout signal.
Right.
He's pointing.
Right.
So in the official's defense, but there should be time added. And we're told now it's going to be 2.5 seconds.
So they split the difference.
Yeah, exactly. So that's what they put that on the board now. Plenty of time to get a good look off. You're down by two. You don't necessarily need the three. A three would win it. A two would tie it. And they're going to bring, it looks like, Phil Nelson, who's 6'7", to be the on-the-ball defender.
I wouldn't be surprised here for Montana State to try to get a direct pass into Bunga in the post. Well, they have Brandon Johnson coming off a down screen at the top of the key.
Everybody's out of timeouts now. Bynum to inbound it. Howard, top of the key, against the double. Howard had it taken away, and Portland State is going back to the dance. Back-to-back NCAA tournaments for Ken Bone and the Vikings of Portland State. It was Murray who came up with the big strip at the end.
I was a little surprised by Montana State that time. Going to Bobby Howard.
Bobby Howard has hit the big shots for them late in games this year, games that went to overtime.
Yeah, but do you go to Howard in this particular game? He was struggling. And it was a set play. They were going to him, Terry, as you mentioned, and they were going with the odds, but pretty good defense that time.
Lower right side of your screen, you saw Brandon Johnson, who's had a big game, knocked down threes tonight, last night, calling for the ball wide open. Murray comes up with the big play. Portland State, the number two seed, able to win once again. Dominguez, the 5'6 point guard, going dancing once again, Stephen Bardo.
He put on a terrific display here, especially in the second half, to lead his club to victory.
Ended up being a great one here in Ogden, Utah. Don't forget baseball tonight coming your way in just a moment. That'll do it. Portland State, the 2009 Big Sky champ, 79-77 over Montana State. This has been a presentation of ESPN, worldwide leader in sports. So long, everybody, from Utah.
I'm here with Jeremiah Dominguez, and how's it feel to go dancing once again?
Oh, it feels great. I mean, dream come true again. Back-to-back seasons. I mean, we worked so hard for this. I'm proud of our guys. We stuck in there. Tough game. Good. I tip my hat to Montana State, which is a tough game.
You guys made an adjustment in the second half, and it seemed to free your offense up. Talk to us about that.
Yeah, we spread the court out, got a high pick and roll, and gave me opportunity to penetrate and dish and even score a little bit.
You guys are favored to win the conference coming into this season. You had some bumps in the road, but you seem to handle that down the stretch.
Yeah, we handle it down the stretch when it counters.
All right. Hey, well, congratulations on a great victory. You're going dancing, big man.
Dancing, baby. Right. Thank you.
All right. Congratulations, man. Good job. All right. Congratulations, man.